So let's go to Dirk. He's our expert. And I mean, Dirk, it's happened. So I mean, what are the chances for us to see him again?
There's a chance. There's a chance. It's not a great chance, but there's a chance. But let's go ahead and talk about the sun and the solar storms going on and coronal mass ejections. Well, that's what's going on inside the sun. We're at a solar maximum right now. The sun has an 11-year period cycle where you get the maximum, lots of solar activity, lots of sunspots, lots of storms on the surface of the sun, and then the minimums where there's not a whole lot of activity. But we're in a maximum right now. And so there's lots of activity. We have sun spots that are going on, and it's where you have these magnetic storms that build up and build up. Think of it like a rubber band. You kind of twist it, twist it, twist it, and soon you get to a point where it just kind of lets go, and it's just all that energy is released. Well, that's what happens on the surface of the sun. So what this image is here, this is the sun right here. There's been three eruptions that have taken place, or coronal mass ejections. The first one, that's what's coming through tonight. The second one, which looks a little bit bigger, coming through tomorrow night. And then there's a third one that's coming through. Think of this like waves, again, coming in behind each other, taking a look from above. You can see those waves, they're heading towards Earth. So let's go over here to this graph, and you can see the first wave. This is the energy associated with it. It's decent. The second one, though, is bigger. So the second one tomorrow night gives us a better chance of possibly seeing some aurora. Here's the forecast that's provided by the NOAA Space Weather Prediction Center. And you can see this is where the aurora is, and this is what's called the view line. This is where you may be able to see the aurora. And you can see that tonight's line cuts across much of Washington, northern Idaho, and pretty much all of Montana. Tomorrow night, the line moves a little farther south, where it covers a good portion of Oregon, on into Idaho and Wyoming. And you can see it's getting close to Northern California. So again, that line is not a fast and firm idea of where you're going to see it. You will probably be able to see it below that line. So we could have a chance, again, in the northern portions of California, where we could see some aurora developing. And again, like the last one that came through, it was spectacular to see. Get out and enjoy.